All right, hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Hare, and welcome back to Hare NHL. Today, we're going to be discussing Alex Burrows kneeing Taylor Hal in the head during a scrum where, you know, Hal leveled him, and then he retaliated by wanting to fight him. They came into a scrum like any other hockey game, but this time, there was a little bit of controversy of what happened. So let's check it out. Start the video in 3, 2, 1, now. All right, so here you can see Burrows getting leveled by Taylor Hal, a clean hit. Maybe he may have jumped. You can see Burrows goes right after him, gets a penalty for it, I believe, for this, and he goes straight to retaliation. They start to scrum, a regular fight. Burrows comes out, wants to fight him. Hal doesn't seem like he wants to fight, but gets tackled, and this is where it happens. You could see right there, boom, twice to the head, a knee. Two headshots with a knee. Now, we've seen suspensions and seen penalties being dealt out because of just punches to the head. Now, this is a knee. We're not in the UFC, guys. We're playing hockey, and there is full, and he tries again. So that is something very interesting. You see a guy like Philip Forsberg, who got suspended 3 games for an interference call. But Burrows, you can see right here, he's going after Hal. He's trying to get his attention. I think he gets a penalty for going after him. And then as soon as the play is dead, Burrows is like, oh, okay. You know what? Now I'm going to go after him. And look at him. He turns around and he goes right after him. And I hope we get a good angle, a better angle than the one. The other one was pretty good. Here, this is beautiful. Like, you can see everything that happened. One, two. Two intentional kicks. I don't know how this cannot be intentional. Let's see. You can see it here. This is even a better angle. Ready? You can see. And just here. Ready? One, two. Two shots to the head of Taylor Hal. And Taylor Hal has been battling with injuries recently. He's trying to get back into it. You got 4 minutes for that. Oh, 4 minute power play. Okay, I thought I read it the wrong way. 4 minute penalty for this. And will he get suspended? And how many games will he get? Now, a lot of people are saying 10 games. A lot of people are saying, you know, a lot of games and stuff like that. This is honestly very, very dirty. I think that this is beyond, you know, just a few games. I think this should be a fine and at least, and I agree, 10 games. Because this is ridiculous. This is the NHL. This isn't, you know, the UFC. We're not here to, you know, fight, you know, people. We're not here to, you know, we're here to play hockey. We're, you know, fights happen, okay? We understand that fights happen, and obviously it's a part of the game, but this is way over exaggerated. This is way too much. This is way more than it should be. I think that the NHL needs to say, okay, you know what, that's the line, because if Philip Forsberg gets suspended for his hit, actually I'll show you guys, right, go. So here's the hit, guys. All right, you guys can see this right here. Boom, hits him. Maybe his head got clipped a bit, but it was pretty, you know, self, you know, it didn't seem like his intentions were to destroy him. And we'll show it one more time now. So, I mean, it was pretty innocent. He comes around the boards, gets rid of the puck, and he leans in. His elbow may have been sticking out, but it seemed pretty innocent. He tried to hit as much with the shoulder as he could, but he gets 3 games for that hit. And if Burrows doesn't get more than 5, and we'll show you Marchand's hit now, okay? Go. So here we go, you have Brad Marchand coming in right here, boom, throws the elbow up as he's cutting across, gets Marcus Johansson in the head, and this is another headshot, and this is the thing, these are headshots, these are things that happen in the NHL a lot, but you don't see a guy kneeing another player very often, and that's where I think, personally, that, you know, the NHL should figure out what they need to do. I mean, check out the clip here, okay? You know, Marchand's battling for the puck with Johansson. He's a little angry with Johansson, it might have been, but he gets free. You know, takes a shot on net, rebound comes, and then it looks like he's jumping out of the way, but it also looks like he's purposely going for that. He got 5 games for that, so that's, you know, that's the whole thing. He got 5 games. Now, the thing is, Burrows, you know, does he have a history? Does he have a history of doing stuff? Is Burrows a dirty player? I don't know his history very much, but I do know that this last one with the kneeing was definitely something to look at. It was definitely dirty. It definitely shouldn't be in the NHL, and I think that the NHL needs to look at this and needs to say, you know what, okay, this is too far. This is not hockey. This is beyond hockey. This is like, you know, this isn't a hockey play, but basically, you know, the NHL goes, okay, was this play a part of hockey or wasn't it? When it's not a part of hockey, okay, when this play is deliberately trying to injure a player and deliberately trying to injure and affect a player like Taylor Hal to the head, especially, that's when you got to say, okay, this is enough. You know, you look at guys like who's the player that got suspended 41 games. I saw his play recently. I watched it. I forgot who it was. He played on the San Jose Sharks. He came up high. He hit him in the head on purpose, supposedly, and that was that. And he got 41 games for it. Now you look at Burrows. I know he's not going to get 41 games, but he is definitely going to get, you know, at least, you know, 10 games. I'm going to say it. He's got to get more or around 10 games, 8 games, 10 games. He's got to get it. Will his presence in Ottawa affect the way the game is going? No, because look, their team isn't going to make the playoffs. Ottawa is not making the playoffs this season, so Burrows being there is not going to make a difference whether he's going to make the playoffs or not. Because we saw last year, Marchand getting suspended just before the playoffs, and that wasn't cool because they, you know, that was, you know, on purpose. We thought it was on purpose because we thought he was going to make a difference in the playoffs, so they only suspended him enough games to not miss a single playoff game, so we thought that was kind of weird. But this time, there's no way Ottawa's making the playoffs, so there is no way that this suspension can be good or bad. You know, he's got to get the right amount, and the NHL has to make the right call, because if they don't, the uprising between the fans and the NHL is going to be huge. And this is a huge, huge thing where it doesn't even look like it was by accident or anything. There's no apology. There's no, it was straight up deliberate, and it was to the head, and it was with a knee. Like, how many times do you see a player throw knees to the head? Not very often. And this is crazy because you don't do that in the NHL. You gotta have respect for each player, even if you're angry at them. And this is way too far, and I think the NHL should do something about it and should suspend him 10 games or more, or, you know, something around that, with maybe a fine attached to it. I don't know. Anyways, I want to pass the question on to you. Do you think that Alex Burrows should get suspended more than 10 games? Should he be allowed to play the rest of the season? I don't know. What do you think? Should he be just fined a couple thousand? I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments down below, and share this with your friends who may have thought this was a dirty hit on the Devils. Player Taylor Hall, if you're a Taylor Hall fan, what do you think? Do you think this was dirty? Do you think this was an accident? I think, in my opinion, as a neutral person in the two sides, I don't like Burrows. I don't mind Hall. You know, I'm neutral for both players, both teams. I think that it's a dirty hit, and I think that it was a dirty play by Burrows, and he deserves to get a couple of games for it. So, I'll pass the question on to you again. What do you think? How many games? And I'll see you guys later.